Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vrikha lakya pritesu surabhi rabhipa layantam Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vrikha lakya pritesu surabhi rabhi alayantam Chintamani prakara sadamasu kalpa vriksha lakshabdesu surabhi rabhi alayantam lakshmi sahasa satam Samrahmase bhamanam Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu Kalpa vriksha lakshabhritesu surabhi rabhi palantam Lakshmi sahasra sata samramase bhamanam Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami Venam Kanvantam Aravinda Dalataksham Venam Kanvantam Arabinda Dalayataksham Brahavatam Masitam Buddhasundarangam Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Vajami Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vriksha lakshabhritesu surabhi rabhi palayantam Lakshmi sahasra sata samramase bhamanam govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami Alola Chandra Kalasa Banamala Bangsi ratnangadam pranayakani kalabilasam. Palola chandra kalasam vanamala bangsi ratnangadam pranayakali kalabila asam shyamam shyamam tribhangalalitam niyata prakasam govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami. Venum kannanuntam Aravindadalataksham Marahavatam Samasitam Budasundarangam Kandatva Kotikamaniya Vishesha Shobham Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu Kalpa Mriksa Laksha Vritesu Surabhi Rabhi Palayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Satar Samrama Sepamanam Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. Angani jasya sakalandriya vetti manti Angani jasya sakalandriya vetti manti Pashanti panti kalayanti Chirang jaganti Angani jasya sakalendriya vetti manti Pashanti panti kalayanti Chirang jaganti Ananda chinmaya sadhu Jalavigraha Ananna chinmaya sadhu Ananna chinmaya sadhu Jalavigraha San Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu Kalpa Vrikkhana Khyabriteso Surabhi Rabhi Palayantam. Thank you. अद्वैतयच्युतयनाद्यनन्तरूपम् अद्वैतयच्युतयनाद्यनन्तरूपम् आद्यं पुराणपुरुषं नवजौवनञ्च अद्वैतयच्युतयनाद्यनन्तरूपम् अद्वैतयच्युतयनाद्यनन्तरूपम् आद्यं प्राणप्रसं नवजौवनञ्च वेदेषु दुर्लभ वेदेषु दुर्लभयदुर्लभयात्मभक्तौ वेदेषु दुर्लभयदुर्लभयात्मभक्तौ गोविन्दम् आदिपुरुषं तमाहं भजामि वेदेषु दुर्लभयदुर्लभयात्मभक्तौ वेदेषु दुर्लभयदुर्लभयात्मभक्तं गोविन्दम् आदिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि चिन्तामणि चिन्तामणि प्रकर सद्मसु कल्पवृक्षलक्षाब्देषु सुरभि रविपलयन्तम् पन्थास्तु कोटिशतवत्स सम्प्रगम्य पन्थास्तु कोटिशतवत्स सम्प्रगम्य वायोरथापि मनस पन्थास्तु कोटिशतवत्स सम्प्रगम्य पन्थास्तु कोटिशतवत्स सम्प्रगम्य वायोरथापि मनसो मुनिपुङ्गमानाम् पन्थास्तु कोटिशतवत्स सम्प्रगम्य वायोरथापि मनसो मुनिपुङ्गमानाम् सप्रस्तिजप्रपदसीम्नम् अभिचिन्तत ते सप्रस्तिजप्रपदसीम्नम् अभिचिन्तत ते गोविन्दम् आदिपुरुषं तमाहं भजामि ब Govindam Adipurusham Tamam Bhajami Chintamani Prakara Sadamasu Kalpa Vrikkanakya Abhiteshu Suravira Vipa Layantam Lakshmi Sahasa Sata Sambrahma Se Bumanam Govindam Yad Samtamahabhajami Ananda Chinmaya Rasapti Bhavitabhi Tabhi Jayeva Nijarupataya Kalabhi Ananda Chinmaya Rasapti Bhavitabhi Tabhi Jayeva Nijarupataya Kalabhi Golakayeva Nivasati Akhilatma Bhutam Golakayeva Nivasati Akhilatma Bhutam Govindam Yadiprasam Tamah Bhajami Govindam Adiprasam Tamah Bhajami Chintamani Prakara Sadamasmu Kalpa Vrikkana Khabriteshu Surabhira Vipa Layantam Chintamani.
The materialistic demigod cannot possibly stretch to the transcendental autocrat who is ever inviting the fallen conditioned soul to associate with him through devotion or eternal serving mode. The phenomenal attractions are often found to attempt sentient being to enjoy the variegated position which is opposed to undifferenced monism. People are so much apt to indulge in transitory speculation, even when they are to educate themselves on the situation beyond their empiric area or experiencing jurisdiction, and almost foolishly they dare to declare that God is dead. The songs of Brahma Sanghita as Chintamani Prakara Sadbasu will surely help such souls in their march toward the personality of Godhead in the spiritual kingdom, which is lying beyond their sensuous gaze of inspection. The so-called astronomers cannot even definitely give us information of the visible sky, which is overflooded with sunlight during daytime and moonlight at night. We can, however, learn about spiritual kingdom from the Bhagavad Gita, that it is situated far, far beyond the visible sky, and in that sky there is no need of sunlight or moonlight or even electricity. There are innumerable spiritual planets in that self-effulgent sky, and the gross estimate of that sky is given in the Bhagavad Gita, that the material world, wherein there are innumerable suns and moons, is only 1/4 of the whole kingdom of God. This material world is also part of the kingdom of God. But this kingdom of God is described as made of inferior energy on account of its temporary nature and is compared with a mass of clouds in the sky. When there is a mass of clouds in the sky, there is certainly torrents of rain, and there is a type of creation of new vegetation on account of such rainfall. But in spite of all such variegatedness, manifestation of greenery seen, of fruits and flowers, the whole show is only temporary. When the season is over, everything fades away into different situations and the temporary manifestation comes to an end. Therefore, the material world is called three phases of existence, namely creation, sustenance and dissolution at last. This creation and dissolution is going on perpetually like seasonal changes, and the portion of the vast sky where such temporary variegatedness is taking place and again becoming out of sight is called the material world. And beyond this material manifestation of variegatedness, there is the world of spiritual sky where everything is eternal, full of light, blissful and knowledge, distinct from the non-eternal, miserable existence of ignorance. In the material world, everything is struggling hard for existence. But the cruel laws of material nature will not allow anybody to exist, although every one of us aspires to exist eternally in full, blissful life of perfect knowledge. This information is available in the Brahma Samhita, that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Krishna, and His transcendental form is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. In the spiritual world, not only Krishna has His eternal body, full of bliss and knowledge, but also everyone who associates with Krishna has the same spiritual nature. In the abode of Krishna, which is called Chintamani Dhamma, the land, the trees, the animals, the residents, everything is of the same spiritual nature as that of Krishna. This spiritual nature is expansion of interior energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is called the cause of all causes. It is said that Brahma, who wrote Brahma Samhita after his mature knowledge by meditation, it was revealed in him that by the recollection of Bhakti Yoga, it appeared to him that he is the eternal maidservant of Krishna. Though other mysteries in regard to the condition of the maidservant of Krishna were not revealed to him, Brahma, by dint of his searching self-consciousness, became well acquainted with the ocean of truth. All the truths of the Vedas were revealed to him, and with the help of those essences of the Vedas, he offered this hymn to the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. Sriman Mahaprabhu, Lord Chaitanya, has taught this hymn to his favorite disciples inasmuch as it fully contains all the transcendental truths regarding Vaishnava philosophy. The audience, the hearers of this record, are requested to study and try to enter into the spirit of this hymn with great care and attention as a regular daily function. The first verse is translated, "I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, the first progenitor, who is tending the cows, fulfilling all desires in the abodes built with spiritual gems, surrounded by millions of purpose trees, always served with great reverence and affection by hundreds of thousands of Lakshmis or gopis." By the word Chintamani is meant transcendental gem. Just as Maya builds the mundane universe with the five material elements, so the spiritual chit potency has built The spiritual world are transcendental gems. The Chintamani, which serves as material in the building of the above Supreme Lord's place, Goloka, is a far rarer and more agreeable entity than the philosopher's stone. The purpose tree, only the fruits of piety, wealth, fulfillment of desires and liberation. But the purpose trees in the abode of Krishna bestows innumerable fruits, yielding the fulfillment of desire for oceans of milk in the shape of the 14 love-sovereign transcendental bliss that take away with the hunger and thirst of all pure devotees. The trees in the abode of Lord Krishna can supply anything desired by the devotees. The devotees residing in the abode of Krishna have not desired to fulfill. Still, there are variegated transcendental desires of the devotees to satisfy their eternal Lord in loving service. In the material world, a tree can supply only the fruits that it can produce, but in the spiritual world, any tree can supply any amount of fruits or any variety of fruits to the aspirant devotee. The second verse is translated, I worship Govinda, the primal Lord, who is adept on playing on his flute with blooming eyes like lotus petals, with head bedecked with peacock feather, with the figure of beauty tinged with the hue blue clouds, and his unique loveliness charming millions of gopis. The matchless beauty of Krishna, the Supreme Lord, or Govinda, is being described. Krishna, the all-pervading cognizant, has the spiritual form of youth. The form of Krishna is not a fanciful creation of imagination, formed after visualizing the beautiful things of the world like the poet or the artist. When Brahma saw in his ecstasy trance of pure devotion, he is being described. Krishna is engaged in playing upon his flute that attracts the hearts of all living beings. Just as a lotus petal produces a pleasant sight, so the two beautiful eyes of Krishna, who causes the manifestation of our spiritual vision, display the unlimited splendor and beauty of his moon-like face. The loveliness that adorns his head with peacock feather is gorgeous. The surrounding feature of the spiritual beauty of Krishna, just as a mass of blue clouds offer a specifically soothing, pleasant view, the complexion of Krishna is analogously tinged with a spiritual dark blue color. The beauty and loveliness of Krishna is far more enchanting than that of Cupid multiplied a millionfold. The next verse is translated, I worship Govinda, the primal Lord, round whose neck is swing a garland of flowers, beautified with moon locket, whose two hands are adorned with flute and jewel ornaments, who always reveals in pastimes of love, whose graceful threefold bending form of Shamsundar is eternally manifested. In the sloka beginning with Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu, the transcendental region and the spiritual names of Govinda, in the sloka beginning with Govinda Adi Purusam Tamaham Bhajami, the eternal beautiful form of Govinda, and in this sloka, the amorous pastimes of Govinda, Pranayakeli, means the amorous pastimes of Govinda, the embodiment of 64 excellences, have been described.
Yeah. Hari, Hari.